suffer as a result. So, for example, they build there are a lot of fosses, so rivers that were around, and the whole system of fortifications was one of the most impressive in Europe in that time. Unfortunately, that was the first step to degradate the town, and the second step in 1807, Napoleon sieged the tower, and after 160 days he didn't get Nyssa, but Nyssa decided to surrender because of the famine and lack of food. Napoleon in the precious papers gave the constitution, and he dismissed the role of bishops here. So, for example, this church, we call it cathedral, but it's not cathedral because cathedral in Christian religion is the residence of bishops. We don't have bishops anymore in Nyssa, but the remnants of the old days were quite impressive. So these two events turn Nyssa into small provisional town. But at the end of the 19th century, Nyssa started developing again. Due to a lot of factors, one of the main factors was that there were a lot of railways, because Prussia built really a lot of railways. So our region has a lot, even into villages, they decided to build railways. But as you see, the region was quite plain. So what happened next? As the result of the conference in Yalta, former German territories were given back to Poland. Yeah? So Red Army entered Nyssa, so Soviets, and Germans, fled from the town before. Unfortunately, so without any fight, Soviets took the town. But just for fun, they started burning the buildings. So as a result, almost 70% of all beautiful buildings in this town was burned. That's why we have old communist blocks of flats. Some wonderful ancient monuments and some moderns together. It looks horrible, let's make it this, but that was our history. The majority of people from Nyssa were settled by force from Ukraine, because as you know from the history, the east of Poland was also taken, so territories around Lutsk, Lviv, Rumne, Ukraine, also the majority of Belarus and part of Lithuania. So they were taken to the Soviet Union, and as we took Silesia and Pomerania. Pomerania is the region next to the Baltic Sea. That was 100% Germans, but Stalin decided that all people from Germany were settled by force. Yeah. And all people from the former east of Poland or western Ukraine were settled by force to these territories. At the 2018, they built the monument of Józef Piłsudski. Józef Piłsudski was one of the father of independence. As in 18th century Poland in general lost its independence due to internal and external difficulties, but we were between Prussia, Russia and Austria. They were much stronger and they cooperated together. During the First World War, that was the first time when Germany fought, United Germany fought against Russia, so that was the way that Poland gained independence. And as the 100th commemorate of regaining independence, the monument of Piłsudski, the father of independence, was built. And this is the same Piłsudski S was internal here in now in Ukraine, that was in before Second World War, to show the bond between. Nowadays Nysa is developing, we have quite a nice location because the mountains are nearby and the mountains are impressive. And I can just tell you that, you know, during pandemic times when every Saturday I just took the car with my friends, we went to the mountains to hike, that was a good way to do it. Now it's developing quickly, we have university, as you know, and hopefully some of the places survived the occupation. I'm not going to show everything, but we can walk to see places.
Thank you.
13 bullets. Wow.